you guys are probably wondering why I haven't made a video in so long. So I'm going to be making a hair video for you guys today. It's how I curl my hair. I just curled the side. I'm gonna show you how I curl the side now. Quick trick, yeah, I know. It looks like I had all my hair down on one side, but nope, I didn't. So I'm gonna show you guys how I curl this side. It's kind of curly already because I had it in a braid for a while. And if you guys are probably wondering, I came from work early, so I decided to curl my hair. But I'm just gonna put that out of the way for a second. So I curled this side first because I have more hair on this side because I part it differently. So this side is all done. I hairsprayed it and everything. And now I'm gonna show you guys how I do this hair. So if you guys are probably wondering what I use, you guys probably already know this is the Remington wand. It's pink. It's really small compared to what my sister has. My sister has a different one, which I've curled my hair with her straightener and it worked. So this same technique could go for if you have a regular hair like wand, like a hair curler, or this could work with a straightener if you want to straighten your hair. Not really, maybe straighten, but you know what I mean. But I use this, it's on 374 right now. It's been heating up, and I just curl this side. So now I curl the side, I'm going to be take kind of like brush it out a little. So what I'm gonna do is just kind of just separate my hair like this, like in half, and then kind of twist it up. Now this section, I won't have that many sections for this one because this side is a lot smaller. So this side sometimes doesn't curl as well as the other side, so it comes out weird. That's because why. So I put that up in like a little bone just to get it out of the way. And then I'm just gonna take another chunk because we're just gonna be working on this back side. Just gonna have a little more here. Now I had four on this side, so I'm gonna have only like three sections on this side, but these will only be like smaller sections. So after I do that, I'm just gonna take my 44 iron guard, my chi. You can use Tresemme heat tamer spray if you'd like to, but I'm just gonna spray a good amount. And my hair is kind of curly from the braid I had earlier, and I'm just gonna kind of brush that in, kind of dry it a little faster. Okay, and then now what I'm gonna do is take a few sections of hair from the back, about that thick. Now my hair is very, very thick, so it can take the heat, but if your hair is very, very thin, I don't recommend taking very thin sections. If you have very thin hair, I recommend taking about more than that, like probably about an inch of hair, like more, but I'm gonna do it thinner since so my curls come out a little bit like small. If you like, it depends what kind of curls you want. If you want bigger curls, take bigger sections. If you want small curls, then take a little. I'm just gonna take my wand, make sure it's flat, and roll it up. Make sure it's flat. That's the key, making sure it's flat. And then with the ends, you just wanna keep rolling. And then hold it there for like 15 to 20 seconds. No, 15 to like 10 to 15 seconds. For my hair, if you're doing thicker, do like 20 to 25 seconds. Just until it feels like hot. And then what you're gonna do is let it go. Let it sit in your hand for like a few seconds if it's really, really hot. I mean, you could bobby pin hair until they cool, but you can just let it go like this. Some straightened hair pieces are like in the way. So like that, so you have your curled piece. And then I'm gonna put it over my shoulder so it's like out of my way. So I'm gonna do that again. Take a section. Again, it just depends on your hair type. If it's thick, if your hair is thick, add thinner pieces of hair. If your hair is very, very thin. Now, I don't use a lot of heat on my hair, so that's why my hair is a little bit, like, not as, like, bad or badly unhealthy. I try and keep my hair away from heat as possible, but I only curl my hair when I feel like it or when I have, like, a special occasion, really. Like New Year's or birthdays or stuff like that. You could do, take your finger and run through it. This is what you do before you add your hairspray or else it's gonna be too much. So now it looks like I curled my hair a lot more with that. And then what you could do is go with your hairspray. Mine's just this Tresemme Trust 2 spray for this kind. I've had this for a while. And I add a lot because my hair does not hold curls very easily, even if my hair is really thick. So I'm just gonna put all my hair to one side and take down this section that I've had. And this section. The reason why I took out this section is because this is the back of my hair, so it's easier to put behind the back of me, and these sections are in the front. Because I curled the front of my hair last so I could get better curls in the front of my head. So I'm just going to split this in half again. And this will be the top section of my head. And I am just going to take this. Now, if you don't like suctioning off your hair, you could always just not suction it, but suction it in like ponytails. But that's a little bit more difficult since it's, you know. And then I'm just gonna repeat. Like my hair is really thick, so if you guys could see, it's really hard to see with my camera because my phone is very like messed up right now. It's cracked in the front. Alright. Now I'm just gonna take a few like little sections. Because I want my curls to be kind of nice in the front. And then hairspray. Now, I like to hairspray in each layer, but if your hair like doesn't like holding curl, I recommend curling it every curl you make or every other curl. So that's how I do my hair when it's curly. This side is a little more like big because there's a lot more hair on this side. So, I mean, I have a lot of volume because I have a lot of hair. But if you don't have, like, this much hair, you could always tease it. But my hair is just, it's good. So, I'm just going to leave it like this. Give you guys one little, like, nice look. And I like to take my fingers and kind of just buff it. How I curl my hair with my Remington wand. I don't think they have this kind of wand anymore, but you could check them out at Harman. They might have a similar one, I believe. But it works great. It's good. I recommend using it. And if you want tighter curls or looser curls, just follow what I said and it all works. So yeah, I will be posting more vlogs. Also, check out my vlog channel. It's Mandy Vlogs. Yeah. And I'm sorry I haven't been making videos. I started college, so I've been very, very busy with a lot of homework, and I've been working lately. It's a good deal. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.